taking out the papers, what would I do to myself, but you know my lawyer that if you do within 6 days. So what happens if you just 6 days, for instance, in the current age, can we define an extra state in the box? What is the problem going to arise after all the story is concerned, maybe fixing, how do you see that we can put that in a box and when we're in the moment?
Sure.
Well, you can see it from there, but you can look at the condition relations, and you should consider the case which you're attending, this is by other side. And this is the, you need to work out the condition of this particular unit, I should have. And the issue. So this part is going to generate the effects of dynamics, and this is the side. So this is really this discounts the number of elements which are inside, so this gives you a phase, the final estimation of state, this gives you a phase that counts how many elements are inside, and this is the condition estimation. But this then, the conjugate variable with this A, so this is the shift name, because you have this derivative, you can produce a shift by. If you introduce with the function lambda, you can also shift by lambda, but it's shift with the gradient lambda, which is the range. So you work out the computation algebra starting from the command computation relation, so you see you need to that this is the type of pitch transformation. The charge is disorganized, yes. The extra rate is finite, yes, and on top of that, the problem is that states that satisfy these constraints, so that the lower pitch transformation will not be more than the lower pitch transformation. But the gauge lower pitch transformation will just let it by acting with the gauge address that does not depend on x. So the constraint that the state is by the lower pitch transformation, you write it as the integral over dtx of this object equal to 0. Now, of course, it's the integral equal to 0, the integral equal to 0 as well. This transformation that you can use that is valid in also the system of the condition setup that I would use is local gauge transformation defined as the group of gauge transformation that is generated by gauge transformation with a compact support, actually a support which is restricted to a hardball situation, say 0.5. And now, of course, when you start combining all these local gauge transformations, you get a larger variety of gauge transformations. Now the question is, would you get the global gauge transformations or not? As the gauge group is unknown, okay, that's the interpretation of, of course, if you have a local gauge transformation, something like this. Yeah, especially the synaptic topology of the group of gauge transformations. So the local gauge transformations are called what you should call like the small ones, the ones that are continuously, you can continuously perform to the identity. Now, the global gauge transformations in a initial setup, you can perform them to the identity because you have a phase, and the phase can be as small as you want, and you choose it to the value before the identity. So in this sense, you can get them as a position of local gauge transformations. But this statement will depend on boundary conditions, so we will see this. Yeah. Okay, so the phase gain. So, fine, we don't care about gauge transformations, we want to fix the gauge for that. That can be described if you were in a sandbox. So let's say that we choose green gauge, we try to calculate this different function called FMR. Now there is another class of gauge transformations that is very peculiar of the periodic box, which is the large gauge transformations, which is sometimes called linear gauge transformation, but only linear because the phase factor that you use is perpetual complex. Okay. Now this is, this gauge transformation cannot be obtained by computational gauge transformations. You cannot perform them to the identity because this, in order to ensure that you don't break, you don't violate the conditions of the segment, this number here, this n, as we pass to the integer. Now, of course, when you fix the gauge, and fix the gauge in the current gauge, these are local gauge fixing. You're going to fix the local gauge transformation, so the part of gauge transformation that are continuously connected to the identity, and this gauge transformation will still be the symmetry of your action. In fact, okay, so how do we act? We act as a phase, which depends on x on the silent field, and as a shift on the gauge field. Now, under this gauge transformation, the field psi is not invariant, and the field psi gets a phase that depends on this position. So this field will get one phase, this field will get another phase, and you find out this function is different from 0 only if x is equal to 0. So this function is proportional to delta. So, for now, the structure of the gauge group, even when you think of gauge fixed, so this gauge field will fill more, is such that you are not able to define an electron state in a gauge. Now, you see that at least in this kind of setup, this problem is intrinsically related to the fact that you can actually do this transformation. So you can shift the gauge field by constant, and this tells you that this problem is related to the gauge field that's going to be modes. Okay, if you have a setup in which the field in the bucket of 0 modes, you are not allowed to do this transformation, you destroy this symmetry from the random, and then you get that this transformation can be consistently different from 0. So what can you do? One of the ways to, in this picture, there are lots of that are how to deal with this problem. And kind of the very first thing that you think is that, okay, we just kill the node of the gauge field by hand. And this is the description that is now that you can call the QETL. So you just enforce this constraint. So now this is the maximum space. So this is the two-momentum component. This constraint of the gauge field. Of course, this is a finite volume kind of constraint. When you take this volume, this constraint doesn't mean anything because, okay, the cost I want to see is that if it's volume, in fact, when you stress this at a moment, if it's volume, the two-momentum component is a type of zero measure in the transform of the gauge field. In fact, in this case, if you just put QED with the boundary conditions, then you still have it. Yeah. I mean, of course, the probability of the is not the thickness per se. It gives you a headache for if you want to estimate expansion because the probability is not very high in mode, so how you have to do the mode, not effectively. If you're testing the thick sector, if it's a zero charge sector, this is my issue. Right, so this is really related, this is really a problem because we want to find space with nuclear charge. So for space with nuclear charge, Now, starting with this, you also noted that it's not numerical in time, which means that you don't have the Hamiltonian anymore, so you have to set the residual functions as the sum of exponentials, which is particularly bad, especially if you have masses. So this LSP is the QBL, which is the one that's been used by number for the calculation. This is, you need a bit more, so you need the order mode of the gauge field, with special momentum equal to zero, okay, not any temporal momentum. There are other possibilities, and there is actually one that was recently proposed, of course, this is also not the big mass of the photon, but it was recently proposed as a practical way to actually make observations. So actually, it's not really another approach. Now, the reason that the definition that started before is that we want to find a way to deal with this problem, especially that you don't break the height. Now, clearly, these constraints, these kind of constraints here, they are not local, because it's a constraint of an integral of the bridge field. And this one is much better than this one, because this constraint is local in time, even though it's not local in space. Now, the question is, what do you mean by local? The first one and second one is why do we want to have a local prescription? So I'm trying to address these two questions. Okay, there are lots of ways to define locality. If you go back to kind of mathematical quantum theory literature, locality is really defined with microcausality, which is the usual idea that we have is that the computer of two local fields in different points of space at the same time, it has to vanish for separate points. Okay, and it has to be at the value of empty. Okay, now this is the part of the way to see it, which is in fact the equivalent to this one, is the rotational motion of the fields, which can see classically the fields of operators on the space. And to be a local differential equation. So the rotation of the field depends only on fields and the relative fields in the same point, and not by the value of the field somewhere else in space. Now, of course, we want to translate this principle in a kind of particular setup, and so the way is that the theory in the local, if you really can find a formulation in which your potential function is a particular over local field, with an action that is a local function, is an integral over the random density, which is a function of the field, and the only constraints that are allowed to use are things like boundary conditions, which we define only in the geometry of the space, and the local constraints. So, for instance, we're not showing some kind of boundary conditions, which affect the middle of the field in some coordinate equal to zero. This is kind of a tricky point, because you might have a theory which is similarly local, which you write in, and you have a partial function which doesn't really have this form, but in fact you can do a change variable and you find a way to formulate your theory just from here. This happens all the time in physics, and practically it happens to QB equal H. It looks like a normal theory, but in fact it's. The point is that, okay, if you want to have locality, you need to find that you are in a certain variable in which locality is my certain, then you're sure that you're fully proper. Boundary conditions, absolutely, yes. But that's the design, because the competence always local, anyhow. I'm sure it's not a boundary condition. And you know how it works, because the way it works is that you eventually pass a more dimensional fit theory coupled to a higher dimensional fit theory. So the generation pattern is more complicated, sure, but the general principle are not verified. So you need to take into account the potential of the boundary at the symmetry, which allows you to show the set of operators that you need to consider. But aside from that, everything works. Like some other conditions, any boundary conditions, because these are really not constraints. I mean, these are really the boundary conditions. Really, is a situation where you cannot describe the torus with a simple coordinate set, but you don't have even test this boundary system. So the external boundary really comes from a geometrical boundary to your right. You don't have this problem. So yeah, that's something to keep in mind. But there's a sort of machinery to do this kind of stuff. Okay, why do we want locality? Because locality is really a crucial function behind the second number of fields and properties that we give for granted. We don't mind about counting, okay? With these colors, that's the boundaries. You need to take into account the symmetry, but that's the boundaries. When I just start to the symmetry properties of the... Let's start with the critical mass there, and you start with the critical mass, the initial point of space simulation. The fact that the height of the operator function is a consequence of locality among other things, of course. The fact that you can describe your relevance of physics as a local effective theory, and also the whole semantic equivalent problem is based on locality. The fact that you can have local operators to prove the key of the effect, square effect, that's based on locality. If you base locality, you basically are going to break this effect. Now, these are all issues are related to each other, and they're all, realized from the fact that you do actually have operator expansion. So it's the same ways in which operator expansion manifests itself in different types of problems. Okay, so does it mean that if we have another formulation with the but